We are starting with a chapter, Arc and Chord Properties. Very, very important chapter. Now, from the name itself, you can understand Arc and Chord Properties. So, you should know the meaning of the word Arc and the Chord. Then you go for the properties of Arc and Chord. By this time, what I feel, dear students, you must be very clear with what is an Arc. You must have done this. You must have seen what is an Arc is. If not so, let's go for a small revision of it. See, I have drawn one circle with center O. Can you see that? I have taken some points on the circumference. Point A, Q and B. Yes, this AB or AQB is nothing but one of the arc of the circle. A portion on the circumference. A part on the circumference. A segment on the circumference. Or a base of the circumference is known as arc of the circle. So, AQB is the arc of the circle. Yes. And if I join the point A and B, I get a chord AB. Yes. So, arc is converted into what? A chord the moment there is a segment joining the point A and B. So, now you understood what is an arc and what is a chord? Yes. With the help of these two, the combination of arc and chord properties will give a rise to some of the very wonderful properties and the concepts and theorems. In this chapter, we are going to study about that. We are going to study about the combination of arc and chord properties. We start with the first property. In short, we are studying the first theorem of arc and chord property. I read the first theorem, how it goes about it. The first theorem says, the angle that an arc of a circle subtends at the center is double that which it subtends at any point on the remaining part of the circumference. Yes, we read once again. We revise once again. What is the first theorem? Okay. So, what is given to you? The angle that an arc of a circle subtends. Subtends means what? Makes. Makes where? At the center is double. Double of what? That which it subtends at any point on the remaining part of the circle. In short, what I want to say is the angle at the center is twice the angle at the circumference. It's a short meaning of it. We'll take some examples for this. See now the circle in front of you. Yes, see the first part of it. AB is what? An arc. And the angle which is formed with the help of AB is nothing but what? AOB. Yes, angle AOB is formed with the help of an arc AQB. Now this angle, which angle? Angle AOB is nothing but twice the angle. Which angle? Twice the angle APB. This is the concept. Similarly, I have taken one more circle. See the next one. Over here, angle AOB is double the angle APB. The difference is nothing much, but I have taken the angle P on a different side of the circumference. But once again, the concept is same. Because the angle P and angle O are passing from the same arc, that is what AB. But one is on the center and other is on the circumference. So the angle which is on the center is twice the angle at the circumference. See the third circle. See what is given to you. Yes, angle AOB. Can you see that angle AOB? Very good. Is double, is twice the angle APB. In all the three circles, the concept remains what the same. What is that? Central angle is twice the angle at the circumference. Central angle is twice the angle at the circumference. Or what I can say, the theorem which is given to me. The angle that an arc of a circle subtends. Subtends where? At the center is double that which it subtends at any point. When I say any point on the circumference. At any point, okay, on the remaining part of the circle, on the remaining part of the circle. The theorem looks very much easy. We are going to use the theorem in so many sums which are going to do it. Similarly, we pick up the next theorem, the second theorem of this chapter. Now, what it says now, we read this. Angles in the same segment of a circle are always equal. Let's take one example, see what is given to you. Now, you see the figure which is given to you. See the figure very carefully. I have given one circle to you. in this circle, there are two angles on the circumference. So what is the angle QAR and angle QBR? See these two angles very carefully. Angle QAR and angle QBR. What do you see from here? Both these angle A and B are passing from which arc? Yes? Yes. And arc QR. Both the angles A and B are passing from the arc QR. So what do we come to conclusion? Whenever two angles are passing from the same arc and they are on the circumference, their measurements are equal. That was a theorem. Angles subtending from the same arc always were equal in the same circle. And I hope you understood that. Very, very useful thing in doing the sum. Okay, we go for a third theorem of the same chapter. What is the third theorem? What's the third theorem of the same chapter? See the theorem which is given to you. The angle in a semicircle is a right angle. I read once again. The angle in a semicircle is a right angle. Or in other words, what I can say, diameter subtending onto the circumference is always 90 degree. Diameter subtending. Subtending means what? Moving ahead and meeting a point on the circumference is always 90 degree. Yes, see in the figure which I am giving to you. We'll make it more clear. See the figure now. In fact, see the circle. So what I have given to you, there is one circle with center O. Can you see that? Yes, very good. Now there is a AB, which is what, a diameter? Correct. Now this diameter is moving where on the circumference? At point P. And this point P is where on the circumference? So what do I come to a conclusion? Therefore, angle APB is nothing but 90 degree. Yes, this is the theorem. This is the concept. This is the property that a diameter subtending onto the circumference is 90 degree, or what I can say, the angle in a semicircle is a right angle. Now we move on to the another concept, another property of the same chapter, which says if equal circle or in equal circles, that means in the same circle, if two arcs subtend equal angles at the center, they are equal. In short, if there are two angles from the center equal, they'll subtend what? Equal arcs. Equal angle will subtend equal arc. Equal angle will subtend what? Equal arc in the same circle. Yes. In short, equal angles from the center will give rise to equal arcs. Or the converse of this will be what? Equal arcs always subtend what? Equal angles. I revise once again. Equal arc will give a rise to what? Equal angle on the center or on the circumference. What is the figure given to you for your understanding? There are two circles I given to you. Okay. There is one with the center O, the other with the center what? O dash. There is one arc over there, AB. There is an arc what? CD. What I given you, both the arcs are what? Equal. The marking AB is what? Equal to what? CD. So definitely, what do you come to conclusion? If two arcs are equal, they will definitely subtend equal angles. In short, if I say the arc AB is equal to what? CD, it will definitely give rise to what? Equal angles. That is, angle AOB will be equal to what? Angle CO dash D. Or if these two angles are equal, they'll give what? Rise to what? Equal arcs. It's a pretty interesting one. I hope you have understood it very well. Similarly, it goes for two chords also. Now you know what are the chords of a circle. Suppose one circle has got two equal chords. So there is one important property which comes. Equal chords will always subtend equal angle, either on the circumference or on the center of the circle. In short, what I want to say, equal chords give rise to what? Equal angles on the center or on the circumference. See, for example, what I've given to you. See the circle. I've drawn one circle over here with center O. Now there are two chords which are equal. Chord AB is equal to chord BC. Now chord AB and BC, they are subtending. They are making the angles on the circumference. Or which are the angles they are making? See the angles which are made with the help of these two chords. Angle APB and angle BPC. Now because the two angles are coming from equal chords, so definitely they are what? Equal. So what I come to conclusion? that angle or measurement angle APB is equal to measurement angle BPC. So what I come to a conclusion, if two chords are equal, they'll give rise to what equal angles on the circumference or on the center. And the vice versa of it, or the converse of it. If two angles are equal on the circumference, they'll always give rise to what equal chords. Yes. That is, if the angles are equal, the chords which are subtended by them or which are made by them on the circumference always what equal. Now, taking the last property of this chapter, the last concept of this chapter, in fact, the last theorem of this chapter, see what it says now. If two chords, how many chords? Two chords, both are required. Two chords intersect, not bisect, intersect. There's a difference between intersect and bisect. Intersect, that means they are just meeting at a point. Intersect where? Either internally or externally. That means there's two chords are either intersecting in the interior of the circle, in the interior of the circle. Where? Interior of the circle or in the exterior of the circle. Or in the exterior of the circle. So what happened? Then the product of the length, product means multiplication. Product of the length of the segments are equal. Product of the length of the chords are what? Equal. Do you understand this? Let me make you more clear with the help of some diagram, with the help of some figure. Let's make you more clear with the help of some figure. See the first one which is coming now. I have taken one circle, okay, with there's no center, but there's a point X I given over here. Now, these two chords, chord AB and CD, are intersecting in the interior of the circle at point X. Not bisecting once again. Intersecting in the interior of the circle. So, what do I get? What do I come to conclusion? Product of these two chords are definitely going to be equal. That is, XA into XB will be equal to XC into XD. Okay? I take it once again. XA into XB will be equal to what? XC into XD. You can prove this with the help of similarity also. And there's so many ways out actually. But this is a concept. Shall we prove with the help of similarity? Okay, let's try. Let's go for it. I'm taking two triangles, triangle AXC and triangle DXB. I've taken two triangles, triangle AXC and triangle DXB. Now my first job is to prove these two triangles are similar. Yes, angle A is equal to angle D. Can you see it very carefully? Just now we have done, angles in the same segment always what equal. So angle A is equal to angle D. Can I say angle AXC is equal to angle DXB? Vertically opposite angles. So by AA test of similarity, can I say two triangles are similar? Yes, which two triangles are similar? Triangle AXC is similar to triangle DXB. The moment you have proved two triangles are similar, the corresponding sides are in proportion. What happened? The corresponding sides are in what? Proportion. That is, AX upon DX will be equal to what? XC upon XB, which is nothing but AC upon DP. And by cross multiplication, what will get? I'll get XA into XB is equal to XA into XD. That's what I wanted to prove. I have taken one more circle where the chords are intersecting in the exterior of the circle. See the next one. There are two chords, chord AB and CD, are intersecting where? In the exterior of the circle at point X. Now the same property, rectangular property of a circle, we also call it rectangular property of circle, or we say the property with the help of two chords when they are intersecting in the exterior. What I get? XA into XB, same thing, is equal to XC into XD. Whenever two chords intersect, either in the interior of the circle or in the exterior of the circle, the product of the lengths of the chords are equal. That is, XA into XB will be equal to what? XC into XD. Now, I want to give you one of the most important part of this chapter. One of the most special thing which I have drafted for you. Something very, very important. Yes, you will appreciate once you understand this. How to find the radius when two chords are given to you? Or whenever two chords are intersecting either in the interior or in the exterior, we have to find the radius of that particular given circle. It is specially designed for you. It's only for you people. See what we have done for you. Mark it very important. See the first circle. I have taken one of the chord to be as a diameter. I want to find the radius. Yes. So one of the chord I have taken as what diameter? Because diameter is the biggest chord. I want two chords. So I have taken one of the chord as what diameter. That will help me to find the radius. See the figure very carefully. I have taken chord PQ. I have taken chord PQ, and PQ is nothing but diameter. I have taken one more chord, that is what AB. Now these two chords are intersecting at point X. O is the center over here. But this chord is intersecting where? At point X. So by using the rectangle property, how to find the radius over here? How to find the radius? Now see over here. XA into XB is equal to R square minus OX square. This is the formula which we had drafted for you. I revise once again. XA into XB is equal to R square minus OX square. Now OX is nothing but the distance from the center to the point of intersection. Over here is what? OX. So you write OX. But in exam, suppose these two chords are intersecting at point P. Now don't start searching OX over there, because X is not there at all. Over there you are going to find OP, because the distance from the center to the point of intersection. In this case it is what? OX. Very good. See the next figure, where the two chords are intersecting in the exterior of the circle, outside of the circle. Same thing. XA into XB is equal to OX square minus R square. See the difference over here. XA into XB is equal to OX square minus what? R square. So what's the difference between the two? If the chords are intersecting in the interior, so it is R square minus OX square. And if the chords are intersecting in the exterior, it is OX square minus R square. Believe me, this will definitely help you to a greater extent to do the sums on this chapter. It might even click in your exam. It's a very important concept. Learn it very well. I wish you all the best.